Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this tutorial we'll write a Python program to print a pattern. That is, we want to print stars in the pyramid shape, that is in this shape. So without talking much, let's begin with the program. Like previous pattern programs, to print this pattern also we need to ask the user to enter the number of row. We don't ask about the column from the user because here columns are related to rows. So first we need to take the input from the user, and in the input we need to ask the user to enter the number of rows. So in the Python file, first I'll take a variable called n and I'll use input function to take input from the user. I'll write a message, enter the number of rows, and here I'm using Python 3, and in Python 3 by default this input function will take input as the string value, but here we want number of row, that is an integer value. That's why we need to convert this input to integer using int function. Now whatever the input entered by the user, that integer input will be stored in the variable n. So the number of rows will be stored in the variable n. Next, we want to print stars in different row and column, right? To print stars in different row and column, we can use nested for loop, that is for loop inside the another for loop. So we'll take two for loop, one is for row and another one is for column. First, we'll take the for loop for row, inside that we'll take the for loop for column. That is because we'll print stars like this. Here first we'll consider row 0, and in the row 0, we'll print space or star in each column. After completing row 0, we'll go to the row 1 and we'll print star or space in the required column. After completing that, after printing all these stars or space in the required column, we'll go to the row 2. That's why first we need to take the for loop for row. Inside that we need to take the for loop for column. So let's take the nested for loop here. So here I is a variable which is representing row in our program, and in the range function I need to mention how many rows I want in the output. Here we want n rows, right? We ask the user to enter the number of row and we store that input in the variable n. So we want n rows. Here I'm taking range from 0 to n. So when I enter n as 5, we'll get row 0, row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, total 5 row but beginning from 0. Inside this we need to take the for loop for column. So here j is the variable which is representing column in our program, and in the range function I need to mention how many columns I want in each row. So here we can see in a row we need to print space first, after that we need to print star. In a row, we need to print space first, after that we need to print star, right? So we need to take two for loops here. Inside the for loop for row, we need to take two for loop. One for loop is to print space and another for loop is for star, to print star. So because first here we want to print space, after that star, we need to take the for loop for space first. After that, we need to take the for loop for star. So let's take the for loop for space here. So let's check how many space I want in each row. Here we can see 1, 2, 3. We'll get this output when n value is 5. This is the I value and this is the j value. When I is 0, I want 4 space. When I is 1, I want 3 space. When I is 2, I want 2 space. When I is 3, I want 1 space. And when I is 4, I want 0 space. That's why I'll take the formula as n minus I minus 1. We already discussed about this formula in the previous tutorial while explaining about this pattern. For example, when n is 5, I is 0, minus 1, I'll get 4. That is nothing but here, 4 space. When n is 5, I is 1, 5 minus 1, 4, 4 minus 1, 3. I'll get 3 space, okay? So this formula will work for this pattern. That's why here I'll take n minus I minus 1. I want n minus I minus 1 space in each row. Next here I want to print space. Here I'll take end parameter. End parameter will keep the control in the same line. After printing one space, to print the next space we need to keep the control in the same line. We want to print space in the single line, right? Here we can see after printing this space, I want to print this space next to that. So that's why I'm using this end parameter. So we are done with the for loop for space. Next we need to write the for loop for star. In the range function, I need to mention how many stars I want in each row. Here we can see when I is 0, I want 1 star. When I is 1, we need 2 star. When I is 2, we need 3 star. When I is 3, we need 4 star. When I is 4, we need 5 star. That is nothing but in each row, we need I plus 1 star, right? When I is 0, row is 0, I want 1 star. So that is nothing but I plus 1. So in each row, I want I plus 1 star. So here I'll write I plus 1. So here I need to print star. So I'll print star. And here I'll take the end parameter. And here I'll take end as space. That is because here you can see after printing this star, here is a space. After that, I need to print this star. We need space between each star. That's why I'm using here end is equal to space, right? So next here, I'll use print function. This is for new line. After completing one row, after printing stars or space in the one row, next I need to go to the next line to print the stars or space of next row. So that's why I'm using this print function. So let's execute this now. Enter the number of row. I'll enter number of row as 5 and here we can see our pattern. If I enter 10, here we can see. And one more thing, if you forgot this space, if you remove this space, I'll get different pattern. I'll show you that. So if I enter 5 now, we'll get this pattern. Okay. The difference between these two pattern, that is the pyramid shape and the right triangle shape, is here is a space. Okay. Space between the star. We can print this pyramid pattern in another way also. We can print stars like this also. In the first row, I want 1 star. And in the second row, I want 3 star. In the third row, that is I2, when I is equal to 2, I want 5 star, right? We need odd number of star in each row. So to do that, you can use here. This is same. We need same number of space. Here you can take 2 multiply I plus 1. We need odd number of stars in each row, right? That's why you can use 2 star I plus 1. Now if I execute this, so if I take 5 and here we can see we are not getting proper shape. That is because we don't want space between the each star. I need to remove this. Okay. So now if I execute this, here we can see this pattern. So when you are printing the first pattern, you need to enter here space. You need to give space between each star. If you are printing the second pattern, then no need to use that space. And here you need to take ranges 2 star I plus 1. Because we need odd number of stars in each row, right? Okay, so this is about this pattern. That's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.